Why, hello there, YouTube, and welcome to a random review. I am Random Russ, and today I'm reviewing John Wick Chapter 4. So this is directed by Chad Stahisky or something, and written by Shay Hatton and Michael Finch. Michael Finch. Starring, of course, Keanu Reeves, Donnie Yen, Bill Skarsgard, Laurence Fishburne, the late Lance Reddick, which I think is his last film, I think. With Scott Adkins, Clancy Brown, and Ian McShane. So this is the fourth, and I'm assuming the final chapter of the John Wick franchise, where John Wick, we followed him throughout three films. In this fourth film, he fights for his freedom, and basically, he is then challenges Bill Skarsgård's character. What's his name? I can't, I'm not even going to try and read out that name. He challenges him to a duel, he doesn't challenge him to a duel specifically. I don't want to give any spoilers, but he's challenged to a duel and must overcome all these obstacles as well of henchmen and hitmen to fight for his freedom. So that is the story there. As it's freshly new, I will not give too much away. So what did I like about this one? Well, I liked that this was, probably Keanu Reeves' last go at John Wick. I liked the action in this. From the beginning to end, it was non-stop action. So we got a lot of action in there, and a lot of good cameos and from big actors and that, as well as supporting actors such as Ian McShane as Winston Manager. He has always been a good supporting character throughout the films, and probably his character's always looked to John Wick as a son. And I did enjoy Ian McShane's performance. Also, Lance Reddick, it was shocking that he passed away, on St. Patrick's Day. Keanu did say this film will be dedicated to him. So I like to think that, it is dedicated to him. But his role in it was very brief too. And I was like, that is so ironic yet sad because, but we also had some newcomers as well as some old returning faces. We got Bill Skarsgård as like the main villain in it. And we got Clancy Brown as well in a supporting role, or as I know him as Mr. Krabs from SpongeBob, but he is known for playing a villain as well. I also thought, action sequences, especially the one where he's in Japan fighting off all the, Japanese guys and stuff. That's a cool scene. I also like the Japanese character in it, Kane, who was blind and an old friend of John Wick's. He was a very interesting character too, and I liked him as well. He was like Daredevil because he just was badass with his senses, because he was blind. I also thought, Bill Skarsgård was good in it, playing like the villain in it. He's always good at playing a villain, like Pennywise in It. This had some good action, like I say, from start to finish. And there were a lot of brutal kills in there, a lot of brutal violence as well, but not as brutal as the last installment. But I do have my negatives on this one, I'm afraid. Yes, I do. I thought this film was on a long time. I mean, it is on a long time. It clocks in at 169 or 170 minutes. That's 10 minutes away from being 3 hours long. So this film is a long one. So sitting down to watch it is a bit of a commitment. And I do feel it did go on a lot longer than it needed to. I mean, like I said, there was all the action in between it and stuff. But, eventually at a few points, there were bits where it was a little bit of a snooze fest. I actually, you know, managed to keep myself awake. I had to, like, stand up and stretch and, you know, have a quick scroll on my phone because, like I said, this was a long film and there were moments that did drag. And also, there were some scenes where, you know, John Wick wasn't in every scene. I mean, yeah, focus on other characters, but I feel we didn't see loads of, like, Keanu in, like, the first... Well, he was in the opening act and, you know, was in the first act of the film, but, you know, he didn't get as much screen... Well, despite the length of the film being nearly 3 hours, he didn't get, like, screen... let's just say he didn't have the screen time as much as I thought he would, but he did get a lot of screen time in the film. After all, he is the titled character, John Wick. Then still, there were humorous moments in there. There were some funny moments as well that I thought was, you know, nice to add in there. Not as many, though, as the previous films. But like I say, this film is a long one, so if you were going to see this in cinemas, you know, just prepare for that long sit down and watching it, and there are bits that can drag on. And will I see this again? Probably when it's available on home media, because like I say, when a film's on that long, I only tend to see it in pictures once, and then I'll probably just wait till it's available to watch from home, because at least then I can play and pause it, because like I say, a long film. But you know, those almost 3 hours did fly by though. But like I say, there were just little bits in between that did drag, but not too much. You know, and was this silly? Well, it was a bit silly, but I think this franchise has, you know, had its day now. You know, given how it ends, I think they know to end it now, because I don't think there's any need for any more John Wick films. I just really hope Hollywood doesn't get greedy and want more money and turn it into a cash cow. They have no reason to at this point. Just leave it there, Hollywood. Please just leave it at 4. 4 is enough for this series. So, yes. Is it as good as the other 3? I will say probably not, but it's still a watchable, entertaining film. So what am I going to rate this one? You know what, I will probably give it 3.5 out of 5. So, very watchable and very good. It's not a bad film, but like I say, there were just moments in there that did drag on, and I'm afraid it did cost it half of a point from me. So 3.5 from me, 3.5. So almost 4, but I probably won't give it a 5 out of 5. But there you go, that's just how I roll. So yeah, there we go. There has been my review on John Wick Chapter 4. Have you seen it? Let me know what you think down below in the comments. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up and to share with your friends. And feel free to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already and to hit that notification bell. I've been Random Ross, and this has been a random review on John Wick Chapter 4. So until next time, I bid you all a goodbye, friends. Goodbye.